The British government is urging people to stay home, but the Prime Minister has so far ruled out a lockdown. Now, parts of London's tube network are already shutting down, and nationwide rail services will be cut back starting from Monday. The country is making other moves to deal with the coronavirus, including asking retired nurses and doctors to come back to work. Well, even the iconic changing of the guard at Buckingham Palace has been cancelled, while the Queen issued a message for people to heed the warnings to stay home. Nic Robertson reports from central London.
London's most iconic landmarks are almost deserted. The flags are out, but the tourists and most everyone else are gone. Trafalgar Square, normally bustling, but even this tiny scattering of people may be too many to slow the spread of the virus. The Prime Minister has said that people must follow government instructions ruthlessly. This couple taking a last ride before a rumoured London lockdown.
Yeah, I've heard it's going to happen maybe Friday or something. We're all working from home already. Just came out of Little Cyprus today. I'm just going to get the last bit of kind of fresh air that we can.
The Prime Minister, though, ruling out a hard lockdown of the capital for now.
I want to stress that you know, there is no prospect of us wanting to stop public transport in London or stop the tube or the buses. We're not going to be telling people that under no circumstances, if they really need to go to work, can they go to work.
A few miles away, neighbourhoods still busy. In the line outside the butcher's shop, there is apprehension.
To keep the work going on while you have the little kids with you all the day, that will be the most difficult, yeah. But it's what we have to do. We have to part of a chain that we have to. It's a collective effort, I mean.
UK is too reactive instead of proactive. That's how I see it. But every country has a different culture, a way to do it. Hopefully, we'll be in time to stop any serious spread.
Even without a full lockdown, though, changes are coming. Cuts in bus, rail services, as well as the city's fabled underground service, the Tube.
Up to 40 underground tube stations could be closed. The plan is to keep enough of the network running to allow people in vital professions to be able to get to work.
For some, it would be the end of the line for work.
I won't be able to get work without the Tube.
Really?
Essentially, yeah. That's my only option is to get into central London.
So what happens then?
Don't know. I'll have to stay at home, I guess.
For others, a further step into the surreal.
I had a lot more family arguments recently because we've all been together. I don't know, it'll be surreal. It's a bit weird. It's like being in a zombie film or something.
Nic Robertson, CNN, London.
Well, today is the last day of school for millions of children in the UK. Our Hala Guarani is live from a primary school in northwest London. And Hala, we're seeing colleges, schools, nurseries, everything closing there in London.
Yeah, absolutely. I'm between two primary schools here in northwest London. Parents are going to pick up their kids in about an hour's time, but today is the last full day of classes for millions of kids, except for children of so-called essential workers, doctors, nurses, some delivery people. When we call school districts and councils, though, across London, they tell us they're not exactly sure who that applies to. They're still going through the process, the very heavy administrative and complicated process of trying to figure out who is exempt from this measure, this policy announced of suspending classes for millions of kids. This, of course, against the backdrop of a very, very stretched National Health Service, as you mentioned, Linda, up to 65,000 retired doctors and nurses will be asked to consider volunteering to come back to work in order to confront what the National Health Service itself is calling the greatest global health threat in history. The question is going to be, what happens to all these kids who are at home with parents who sometimes can't afford to keep them at home? Some of them might be hourly workers. Some of them might be freelancers. How will they be homeschooled? What about kids who don't necessarily have access to the kind of equipment that they need, computers, Wi-Fi connections, and the like? This is going to be causing a lot of disruptions for millions of people, and still there is some confusion as as to who exactly this applies to, especially when it comes to the exemption for the kids of essential workers. And you noted it as well, and it's important to note that unlike other European countries, bars, pubs, restaurants, you can see in the street here behind me, there is no lockdown going on in London right now. None of them are being forced to close, and this is leading to many questions from experts about whether or not the UK's approach, which is very different from France, Italy, and Spain, for instance, is the right one.
Just very quickly, Hala, some schools that are facing these sort of shutdowns have given a timeline as to when they could potentially reopen. Is there any timeline there at all?
We are seeing quoted in the UK media officials in the government saying, look, if this extends way beyond several weeks, it might not make sense to reopen the schools before the summer. So you might see a situation where an entire country's school system is shut down until after the summer, until the autumn. And this is going to lead to a situation where academic exams are not being taken, where kids who are supposed to take entrance exams, who are supposed to be graduating from high school or college, are not going to be able to do so in the smooth way that they normally are. This hasn't happened in generations, Linda. And just like in other parts of the world, up to 850 million kids are affected by this across the world, according to UNESCO. This is going to be causing a lot of disruption and a lot of anxiety for parents everywhere.